Zach Stone here from electricalpereview.com, and in this video, we're going to solve a single-phase transmission line problem solving for the capacitance and capacitive reactance together. Ready? Problem states, a 12-mile, single-phase, 60 Hz transmission line has a conductor spacing of 5 feet. Determine the A, the line-to-neutral capacitance, B, the line-to-neutral capacitive reactance, C, the total capacitance, and D, the total capacitive reactance, if the radius of each conductor is 0.2 inches. So this is the same problem as the last one when we were solving for inductance and inductive reactance. Instead, we're solving for capacitance and capacitive reactance. Now, just like before, when we're dealing with a single phase transmission line, there's actually two set of values when we're solving for capacitance and capacitive reactance. We have the what's called the one-way length, same thing as the line to neutral length, same thing as the average amount, same thing as the per phase amount. And that's going to be the capacitance, C, from the hot conductor up into the load. Essentially, it's the capacitance of just one of the conductors. So we're going to solve that for capacitance in farads and capacitive reactance in ohms for the line to neutral or the per phase or the average amount. And then for C and D, we're going to solve for the total capacitance and capacitive reactance from the hot conductor to the load and all the way back through the neutral, through the power source. So we're going to account for both the hot and neutral conductor capacitance values and capacitive reactance. All right, so looking at the handbook formula for capacitance, if we want to solve for the line to neutral capacitance of the single phase transmission line, we're going to need to know the DEQ and what the handbook refers to as GMRc. Now the DEQ of a single phase transmission line, it's just the spacing between the hot and neutral conductor, which is the same, we could show it right here. This is the same 5 feet from here to here as we're looking at this cross-section view here. Now be careful. The handbook uses GMR sub C for this value right here. But really what this value is, it's the radius of either the conductor, if there's no bundle, or it's the overall bundle radius if there's more than one conductor per phase. This particular formula uses GMR sub C, C for capacitance. Make a note of that. This is really just the radius. All right, let's go ahead and solve for the line to neutral capacitance of the single phase transmission line. We have C equals 2 pi times epsilon naught, which we'll get in our calculator, divided by the natural log of DEQ on top, which we said is just gonna be the conductor spacing between the hot and neutral, right? Same value. So 5 feet divided by GMR sub C, which is really radius. We only have one conductor, so we're not dealing with bundles. We're gonna use this radius value right here, 0.2 inches. And this is gonna be in the units of farads per meter. Now, just like in the last problem when we were solving for inductance and inductive reactance, this ratio right here that we're taking the natural log of, the units have to equal, right? This has to be a unitless ratio. It doesn't matter if I'm solving for farads per mile, farads per meter, like here, farads per feet. It doesn't matter what the overall units of for this equation are. I need the same units on top here as the units on bottom, so they cancel. Last time when we did this for inductance, we converted the feet to inches. So we had inches on top, inches on bottom. In this problem, we're gonna do it the other way. We're gonna convert our inches to feet so that we'll have feet on top and feet on bottom just to try it a different way. So I'm gonna leave my 5 feet on top here. On the bottom, I can convert inches to feet because I know there's gonna be 12 inches in every foot. All right, let's use our calculator and solve for the line to neutral capacitance first in farads per meter, and then we'll get out of meters and convert. So in the calculator, I have the fraction sign first, 2 pi. Now to get epsilon naught, we're gonna open our constants menu again. It's really simple. We're pressing the second key and then the left parentheses. Again, epsilon naught, just like mu naught, it's all the way at the bottom of this menu. So to save time, instead of pressing the down key on my calculator a bunch of times, I'm just gonna press up. Up brings me to the very bottom of the menu. Here's mu naught that we used last time for inductance, and here's epsilon naught. So press enter, there's that constant. All right, on the bottom, I've got the natural log, fraction sign, 5 feet on top, and then we're gonna convert the 0.2 inches of our radius to feet by dividing by 12 inches in every foot. So 0.2 divided by 12. I'm already in scientific mode from last time, so the answer is already being displayed by a power of 10. So that's gonna be 9.75 times 10 to the negative 12 farads per meter. All right, just like last time, this isn't my answer just yet. I don't need capacitance in farad per meter. I need the overall capacitance per phase for step A in just farads. And I know my length is 12 miles, right, from the power source to my load. So let's get rid of these meters here by converting from meters to feet. And then let's convert from feet to miles, and then we'll multiply by our total transmission line length of 12 miles. So to get rid of these per meters, I need to bring the meters on top so they cancel. Looking at my conversion factors over here, 1 meter equals 3.281 feet. Next, let's get rid of these feet. Since they're on bottom, we're gonna bring them on top so they cancel. Again, I know that there are 5,280 feet in every mile, right, per mile. All right, last, we're gonna multiply by our transmission line length of 12 miles so that all of our unit lengths will cancel and will be in just farads. So before we do that, before we wanna waste time in our calculator, let's do a quick unit check. Meters on bottom cancels with meters on top. Feet on bottom cancels with feet on top. Miles on bottom cancels with miles on top. And when we run this through our calculator, we're gonna be in the units of farads. Perfect. All right, let's type these numbers in our calculator and see what we get. This value right here is the last value stored in my calculator. So all I need to do is just use the times button to get answer times. That's 9.75 times 10 to the negative 12 farads per meter times. The first one I have times one fraction sign. Here's my 3.281. And I'm gonna move over to the right. Times 5,280, that's my feet and miles conversion, times here's my length of my transmission line, times 12 miles. All right, so in the calculator we get 1.88 times 10 to the negative 7. I'm gonna move that decimal over one place to the left to get 10 to the negative 6, which is micro. It's very common to express capacitance in the unit of farads in microfarads. So instead of 1.88 times 10 to the negative 7, we'll move it over once to the left. 0.188 times 10 to the negative 6 farads, which is the same as microfarads. And that is our answer for step A. So what did we just calculate? We calculated the value of this C right here. That's the capacitance of just the hot conductor, which is equal to the capacitance of just the neutral conductor. Again, this is the per phase capacitance, the line to neutral capacitance, the average capacitance, the one-way capacitance, all different vocabulary words for the same value. All right, we've got our capacitance in farads. Let's go ahead and solve for B. Let's solve for the capacitive reactance in just ohms. So to solve for the capacitive reactance in ohms, we're gonna use this formula right here. Capacitive reactance equals 1 divided by 2 pi times our frequency, of course, is 60 hertz, times the capacitance that we just solved for. So times 0.188 microfarads. All right, let's run this in our calculator and see what we get. So my calculator, again, the last value is this right here, 0.188 microfarads, right? 0.188 times 10 to the negative 6. Same things as 1.88 times 10 to the negative 7. So I'm gonna type in 1 first, divided by 2 pi, 60 hertz, times second answer, right? I wanna use that last value of our per phase capacitance that's already stored. All right, I hit enter and I get, looks like 1.4 times 10 to the 4 ohms. Again, instead of times 10 to the 4, let's express this as 10 to the 3 kiloohms, right? That's a more common way to express ohms. So I can move this decimal over once to the right, and solve that as 14, and I'm gonna round that 8 to 1. So 14.1 kilo-ohms, right? Same thing as 14.1 times 10 to the 3, same thing as 1.4 times 10 to the 4. And that is gonna be our answer for B. So we just solved for this value right here. We solved for this capacitive reactance in ohms of just one conductor. All right, just like before, now it's time to solve for the total amount in this single phase circuit. So it's gonna be a little different than last time. Last time we were dealing with inductors. All we had to do was multiply these values by 2 because inductors sum in series. Capacitors don't, so be careful here. In a series circuit, capacitors add as the reciprocal of the reciprocal sums. It's the same thing as adding resistors in parallel. We can do 1 over C plus 1 over C, where this is the same C and X of C values down here. Or the shorthand I like to use, I'm gonna say, oh, we'll use blue. I'm gonna say CEQ for C equivalent, right? Total C equals C parallel C. Again, this is just a shorthand I like to use. It tells me don't take the sum of these because they're capacitors. So you can use the reciprocal or the reciprocal sums method, or I can multiply them and then divide by the sum. All right, same thing. Equivalent C is gonna be equal to C times C is C squared divided by C plus C is 2C. Again, all I'm doing is I'm adding them the same way you would add two resistors in parallel, right? We know that's how capacitance in farads sums when they're in series. So C squared on top and C on bottom, the square cancels with this C. That means the total series equivalent capacitance is one of these values divided by 2. Again, no different than having two resistors in parallel. All right, so to solve for B, I want the total capacitance. So from my hot through my first capacitance to my load, and then through my second capacitance back to the power source. So these two are in series. So if I want to find the total equivalent capacitance, I've got to divide this value by 2. It's the same thing as multiplying this formula by 1/2, or dividing the total by 2. So for C, I'm gonna take this value right here. Here's the line to neutral, or the per phase value, 0.188 microfarads, and we're just dividing it by 2 to calculate the total amount. So my calculator, I wanna find this number really quick, 0.188 microfarads, right? And it's right here, times 1.88 times 10 to the negative 7, same thing as 0.188 times 10 to the negative 6. I'm gonna bring that value right back down. I don't wanna waste time typing it in my calculator. And all I'm gonna do is do divide by 2. All right, 9.4, we'll say 2. 9.42 times 10 to the negative 8. Let's express this in microfarad. So to get from negative 8 to negative 6, we've gotta move over the decimal place to the left, not once, but 2 times, right? So we're gonna have 0.0942 microfarads. Can you see that? Did that get cut off on the screen? So this is 0.0942. We'll write it down here. How about that? Microfarads. And that is the answer for C. Now, D, if we want to find the total capacitive reactance, X of C in ohms, again, just like the previous inductance problems, we can do it two different ways. First, I'm gonna use the same formula as last time. Then I'm gonna add just the per phase capacitive reactance in series. Again, it's gonna be a little different than how we had to do it with the inductor problem, so be careful. All right, first way, let's just use the same formula right here. X of C equals, and we're gonna call this equivalent for the total equivalent capacitive reactance here in series. So X of C equivalent equals 1/2 pi, our frequency is 60 hertz, times, right here, this is C equivalent, right? times 0.0942 microfarads. I think I was able to fit that all on the screen. All right, so this value is the last value in my calculator. So in my calculator, I'm gonna type in 1 fraction sign, 2 pi times frequency, 2 pi times 60 hertz, times, and I'm gonna use that same second answer button to use this value right here. All right, 2.82 times 10 to the 4 ohms. Again, we'll express that in kilo-ohms. So I'm gonna move the decimal over once to the right. So that's gonna be, we'll say, how about 28.2 kilo-ohms. 28.2 kilo-ohms. All right, this number right here is not this value. This number right here is the value of the capacitive reactance in the unit of ohms for both conductors in series. All right, the other way to get this value, I can take my per phase value and add them up in series. Be careful, we're in the unit of ohms when we do that. Capacitive reactance, it's a reactance in ohms, right? It's like impedance. So unlike capacitance and farads, capacitive reactance in ohms sums in series just like resistors. In other words, X equivalent for the total equivalent capacitive reactance from my hot conductor and my neutral conductor is gonna be X of C plus X of C, right? These two are in series. We just sum them up. We're in the unit of ohms, right? We can simplify that as just 2 times X of C. So let's try that method down here. XC equivalent equals 2 times my line to neutral value. So 2 times the value we got for B, 2 times 14.1 kiloohms. In my calculator, I'm looking for 14.1 kiloohms. So I'm scrolling up until I find it. There it is. I press enter to bring it back down. And again, I'm just multiplying by 2 to account for the 2 capacitive reactants in series. So here's that times 2. And again, look, we get 2.81659, just like we got before, times 10 to the 4. If we want to express that in kiloohms, we'll move the decimal value over to the right once, and that's the same 28.2 kiloohms. So that is our answer for D.